Hey everyone, thanks for tuning in to another WordPress Wednesday. Today wraps up our series that we've done on social media plugins, how to use a hashtag, all things kind of social media having to do with WordPress specifically. We've looked at a lot of different options for Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, Pinterest, all sorts of different networks. So if you've missed all those, be sure to check those out. I'll put some links in the description box below so that you can check those out and get some ideas for how to be using those social networks to improve your branding reach and even to just improve the experience that your users have on those networks. All right, so today I want to talk about how to get your posts in WordPress automatically published, at least to Facebook. I've got a couple of other options that you'll be able to get your post published across the board to a ton of different networks all at once. But I first want to start off by showing you a free option, because if you've watched my channel, you know that free is always in the budget, right? So we want to look at, and I'm just going to show you one here for a second. This again is how to get your blog posts. As soon as you click publish on a blog post, we want it to automatically connect over to your Facebook page and kind of do an excerpt, little blurb over there, maybe also include your featured image over there, and then of course put a link to get people to come back to your website. Now, if you're only interested in using this for one network, you know, Facebook is probably the obvious choice there. It's not too much of a time saver, but if you're really trying to connect across multiple networks, this could really be a time saver for you. Of course, if you're running on the .com version of WordPress, you probably know about Jetpack. Inside of Jetpack, you have an option for something like this called Publicize. So take a look at that one. That's available inside of Jetpack. If you haven't wanted to use this because of just the heaviness, the weight of what Jetpack is on your website, there's another option. So let's do this. We're of course in our dashboard. We are in the add new area, and I want to do a search for AccessPress Facebook is what we're going to do a search for. So you can see that right here, AccessPress Facebook. And this is the option that comes up that we are looking for. This is AccessPress is the developer's name of this particular plugin. I'm not making money off of advertising this. I'm just showing you a solution that I've found in the free range. Now, it only has 9,000 installs. It's relatively new. It has been updated a day ago, so that's great. We know that that this author cares to keep this plugin secure for us. And then, of course, it says here that it's compatible with our version of WordPress. So you always want to check that. If this is later on down the road that you're viewing this video, please be sure before you click install on this that it is up to date, that it's at least been updated within the last 6 months, that it's still compatible with your version, and that it still has great reviews and a lot of active installs. So you just go ahead and click install. And because I'm on WP Engine with my hosting, they of course give you a quick alert and say, hey, are you sure that you want to do this before you do a backup? And I normally just go for it. Living on the edge, people, living on the edge. Once you activate it, you've installed it and you activate it, down here on the left side of your dashboard now, you will have an access point to get in here and run through the settings. Now, all that was pretty simple and straightforward. It's installing any plugin. Here's where it gets a little bit more nerd code style, okay? You wrap your brain around this. Don't get intimidated by this, because all it is simple instruction. We follow the instructions, click through, and we're able to basically build what we call an API or a bridge between your social media network, Facebook, and your website. So we've got to connect the two and give them, in a sense, permission to connect, and that's what we're about to do here. So step-by-step instructions. Of course, it sends an alert right now. It says we haven't done it yet. You need to go ahead and authorize your account to connect with each other. And you're going to be looking to copy and paste in some things here. Now, this gives us clear instruction. Please visit here and create a new Facebook application to get application ID and application secret. So we're going to click here, and I've already got a few created. All you do is click this green button that says add new, and of course I'm already logged into my Facebook account, and we want to connect it with a website. So you click website, and then here you go, quick start for website. You just go ahead and type in what it is, and as you walk through this, at the end of this process, it is going to give you the simple code that you copy and paste into these areas, 1 and 2, and they will tell you that it's an application ID and it's an application secret. You'll be able to copy and paste it in. Then it says click here to get your Facebook ID. You'll click there and it'll tell you what to paste in there. And that's kind of how you do it. You're just going to walk down through all these options. Down here toward the bottom, it's saying, do you want to allow us to auto-publish your posts and your pages, maybe all the other things that you have going on, or simply just your posts for your blog. It's really up to you. You can make that choice right here. And then once you've got all those settings in place, you'll click Save Settings, and you'll be able to start broadcasting these as soon as you click Publish. So if that's kind of too fast, the other cool thing that's in this plugin is check this out. You've got an option right here, how to use. And they've got a quick tutorial video that's probably a little bit more advanced than mine. And they're gonna really help you understand how to set all this up. Just take a moment and read through this. I know we don't always like to read, we like to watch videos. But take a moment and read through these instructions. This developer really wants to hold your hand and get you successfully publishing. Here's the other thing this really cool author will do, is if you're looking to publish across a bunch of networks all at once, they do have a pro version of this. And I'll put the link to this in the description box below. This particular pro version allows you to publish to Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Tumblr all at one time. And it's a $20 one-time fee for you to purchase this pro version and install it and run it. And it, again, it has pretty good reviews. It's still kind of new. And it's just, again, been updated this year, so that's great. If you're looking to go just big and you say, you know what, Kori, I'm using 10 different networks and I really need a time saver and I don't always like having to go over to something like Hootsuite and still set everything up. I really do want that one magic button that as soon as I click it, it blasts out across the board. I'll give you one more. This is a premium plugin, but I'll give you one more option here. It's called NextScripts. Now, for free, they allow you to use one network. So if you're looking to do just Instagram, or if you're looking to do just Twitter or just Facebook, this allows you one free. But the second you want to do more than that, it's going to immediately ask that you buy the pro version. And I think right now it's on sale for like $50 US per year. So it's a little bit more pricey, $50, but check this out. Let's see if I can show you, oh my word, if I can show you like what all, oh, over here, watch this. Look at this, you guys. Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Blogger, Tumblr, Flickr. I mean, there's Instagram in here. There's Pinterest in here. There's LinkedIn in here. There's all sorts of ones that you can just check out and see what all is available. Look at all of these. Just down the row here, all these different networks that it immediately allows you to sync your website to. And with that magic click of publish, it will broadcast out. Of course, each one of these, as you install it, you'll have to make that connection per network at least one time. You'll have to set that up and give permissions for your website to speak to that network, and then you're off and running. I hope this has helped you. If you've used any of these tools, or if you have another one in mind that you've used, would you put it in the description box or in the comments below so that we can all kind of share our knowledge and grow our WordPress community? I hope you're having a great one. I will see you next week for another WordPress Wednesday. Bye, y'all.